The typical hello world of microcontrollers is setting up a little blink light, which is what we're going to do as a first step. So I'm going to take this ESP32 starter template, which we discussed in the previous module, and I'm just going to go ahead and copy that to another directory that I want to work on. And we'll call it Blinky. And let's open this up in Visual Studio Code. Now, if I really want to clean things up, I don't need the README, so I'll get rid of that. I don't need the gitignore, so I'll get rid of that. And I don't need the miscellaneous folder, so I'll get rid of that. That gives me a little bit more of a cleaner starting point. And then I'll go through to main and open up main.c. Now, typically, our ESP32 boards conveniently come with a built-in LED, which is what I'm going to utilize now. If your ESP32 dev board does not have a built-in LED, you can just add an LED to one of the pins with a resistor of about anywhere between 100 ohms and 300 ohms will be fine. So let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is include the GPIO, so that we can actually do some general purpose input and output. Now I'm going to create a hash define to define our pin. This may differ on your board, but for the one that I'm using, it's on pin 2. And for most of the boards I've seen, the LED usually sits on pin 2. Next, I'm going to select the fact that I want to use my pin as a GPIO. There are various different things that we can do with our GPIOs. We can set them as touch, we can set them as A to D or D to A converters, but I want to tell ESPIDF that I want to specifically use pin 2 as a general purpose input output. And to do that, I'm going to do the following. Now I need to set the direction. Do we want it as an input or an output? This function, GPIO set direction, takes two parameters. The first one is the actual GPIO pin number. And the next one is an enumeration that basically tells us whether we want to set it as an input or an output. GPIO mode output tells the ESPIDF that I want to use this particular pin as an output. Now let's go ahead and actually blink the LED. Now I need to actually pause the operation for a little bit. The best way to do that using the ESPIDF is with using the VTask delay function. And for that, I need to include a little bit of the FreeRTOS libraries. Now I can set up this delay. The VTask delay is the standard way of delaying things within the IDF, and it takes the amount of ticks that are going to occur. And in order for us to convert the amount of ticks to milliseconds, we can use the milliseconds and divide that by our rate of ticks, which in this case is a configuration set as port tick period ms. So this over here will give us 1,000 milliseconds, i.e. 1 second. So just to go through it very quickly, GPIO pad, select GPIO, and then we have a pin, and we basically say that we want to set our pin to GPIO pad. Now this by default is actually going to be there, so we could potentially get away with outwriting this particular line of code, but it's a good practice to do this. Then we say GPIO set direction, and we're going to tell it it's going to be an output. And I just have a flag over here to say whether or not our LED is on or off. And what happens now is I go through a loop while true, and I toggle this flag is on. So the first time it comes in here, it's going to be set to 0, and this is going to set it to 1, and then the next time it's going to set it to 0, and the next one 1, and so on and so forth. That's what this is saying. It's saying isOn is equal to not isOn, so it'll change it or toggle it from 1 to 0. Then GPIO set level is going to go either 1 or 0, and then I'm going to delay that. So let's go ahead and try this out. So once again, control backtick or control tilde will bring up this little terminal, and it'll ask me if I'd like permission to set my terminal to allow this particular export or .bat, which is coming from the IDF. So I'll say allow. I'll close it down again, and then I'll reopen it, and it'll go ahead and execute that batch file, which will go ahead and put all of the IDF paths and variables inside this terminal. I can go ahead and clear this now. And in order for me to flash the chip, I'm going to go idf.py flash. Make sure that my file is saved, and let's go ahead and run this. And here we can see it blinking.